Hi, everyone. I'm Apostle Fongmanay Ferguson, Senior Pastor of United Faith Ministries International, where we're reaching people, changing lives. We're located on Fire Trail Road, east of Somalo B. Butler Highway. Here at United Faith Ministries, you will be greeted with a warm welcome. Yes, and you will experience a powerful time of praise and worship, dance, and a very exciting and powerful time in the Word. Are you sick? Are you lonely? Are you feeling out of place? Then visit us in any one of our services every Sunday morning at 10:30 a.m., every Sunday at 8 a.m. For further information, please visit us on our website, www.ufmi.org. I look forward to seeing you. Now remember, this is your time and your season for the glory of God to be revealed in you.
Savior, Jesus the Christ, and welcome to Faith Touch. I am elated that you have taken the time to join us today. Today, Apostle's message is entitled Producing Kingdom Fruit, Part 2. This message helps us to understand that God expects us to bear fruit in His kingdom. This comes through relationship with Jesus Christ. We have the fruit of our lips in praise and admiration to God. Listen, take note, and be blessed.
Listen. Hey. Y'all ready? As I come down, I say the axe is laid at the root of the tree that's not bearing. So what we are going to do? All right then. Chop it down. Listen, the fruit of the Spirit, you must know what they are. It's not something you buy like candy bar in a plastic bag to put in your car to make orange and tangerine start war. The fruit of the spirit must be ripe, ready to pick. Mean like terrible, you have to kill that with lick. Man a fling big stone, some a fling long stick. The fruit where you have, make them know he exists. But if nobody not paying your tree any mind, well it means it's pure leaf they're seeing all the time. So if you wish to be standing next year this time, you better start bear two lime, or else what? Chop, 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 chop it down. Not bearing fruit, yes we have to what?
As we bring to the conclusion on the Sundays, the topic on I will produce, the declaration, I will produce kingdom fruit for God's glory. I will produce kingdom fruit for God's glory. The thing that we must come to the conclusion is that, my brothers and sisters, God's ultimate desire for us, God's ultimate desire for us, my brothers and sisters, is that we as his people are conformed to the image and to the character of his son, Jesus the Christ. Touch somebody and say, neighbor,
neighbor.
I'm on my way, and I won't stop now. God wants us, my brothers and sisters, he wants us to operate operate in who he has called us to be. Amen. This is our time and our season for God's glory to be revealed in our lives. And we should let nothing stop us, brothers and sisters, from becoming all that God desires us to become. Amen. Remember the word of the Lord in John chapter 1 declares, for as many as receive him, to them he gave power or the right to become sons of God. The hour is late, and the enemy is working overtime, brothers and sisters, to keep you from walking in purpose and destiny. I'm not going to be preaching. I'm just going to talk to you. He does not want you, brothers and sisters, to function in the spirit of the kingdom. And so he's doing all that he can to keep you and I in a spirit of defeat. Because if he can do that, brothers and sisters, he has already won. He has already successfully won in frustrating you from what God desires. The Bible declares that Satan's plan for your life is to steal, kill, and destroy. But what's God's plan? God's plan is that you would have life and have it more abundantly. Do you see what just happened just now? You see what just happened? Watch this. When you were in the spirit of jubilation, in the spirit of praise, I want to suggest to you that nothing was bothering you. The thing about the enemy, though, is he has no problem with waiting on you until you finish dancing and jumping. Because when you finish, see, if you don't know who you are and whose you are, he knows that he's going to have his field day once you finish jumping. But what God wants us to do, brothers and sisters, is when we jump, we're jumping because there is something deep down on the inside that's working on the outside. Are y'all in the room? We ought to be in a spirit of jubilation. Nothing confuses the enemy more than a people that's rejoicing when you ain't got nothing to rejoice over. The second thing that God desires for us, brothers and sisters, is that we as the children of God, he wants us to operate, my brothers and sisters, in a mindset that we are called to glorify God. Five ways we're called to glorify God. Of course, there are more, but I'm just list five. Number one, as the light of the world, which means that God has not called you to a little corner. Just as Dr. Nigel Lewis is known by you, a man who comes from a humble country,
Trinidad and Tobago, a little small island when you put it up against such a place like the Americas or Mexico or Australia. Are you all still here? Yeah. But yet his name is known throughout the world. What stops you from being known? You are the light of the world. Number two, you are the salt of the earth. You and I are called to influence our world. Are you all in the room? You and I are called to influence our world. We're called to make a difference. Someone ought to be calling for you in Jamaica. Hello? Somebody ought to be calling for you in Russia. Don't die and nobody has an interest in you. Somebody ought to be excited about your presence. Somebody ought to be believing that when you show up, things are going to change. See what happens when he showed up? Everybody got happy. Everybody got happy when he took the microphone, because guess what? He understands purpose. And because he understands purpose, that is what he lives for. He lives to get people in the spirit of praise and jubilation. You and I, that's what our lives are called. We are called to make a difference. We're called to make a difference. Your assignment may not be causing someone to jump and shout. Your assignment, my brothers and sisters, may be just to love up on somebody. May just be to help shape someone. But whatever that assignment is, the word says you're called to be the salt of the earth. The third thing is we're called to be the righteousness of God. That means that we live right. Amen. It means that we live right. And brothers and sisters, I want to tell you today, you know, in the kingdom, we have a whole lot of struggle on people living right. Are you all here? You know, listen here, man. You got a lot of people with Jesus on their tongues, but they just can't live right. I'm going to be easy. Are you all here? A lot of Jesus, but just haven't made up their minds to walk right. God wants us to live right. Are you still here? The fourth thing is a kingdom mindset. We're not called to be chickens. We're called to operate with the mindset of an eagle. Are you all in the room? Can I find any eagle dwellers up in here? Come on, eagle dwellers. Eagle dwellers don't focus on what's going wrong. Eagle dwellers, watch this, brothers and sisters. Eagle use the struggle in which they saw. What you saying? In this fourth quarter, I need some people to hear me, brothers and sisters. There are some struggles that are going to come your way that God wants you to take advantage of. He says you must use the struggles for your advantage. The eagle uses the storm to soar. And there are too many people that are going through struggles, and their struggles are being used. Watch this. Their struggles are being used to suppress them. When you allow God's assignment to your life to impede you rather than to process you, you missed the way. What are you saying? I'm saying if God allow, and I'm going to show you this in the text in a second, if God allows the struggle to you, for you, brothers and sisters, if you got to say ouch, but keep moving. Say ouch, but stay in the fire. Say ouch, but stay in the water. Are you all here? Say ouch, but stay in his hand. Because he can't do nothing with you when you move out of place. And there are a whole lot of people who will miss their season of manifestation because you don't like the process. Are you all in the room? Stay focused now. Stay focused for just a few more minutes. Stay focused. God wants to do great things through your life. And in order for you to experience this great things through your life, you got to be processed. The man of God just sang a moment ago, if the tree ain't bearing no fruit, are y'all hear it? He didn't say nothing about root it up. He said, chop it down. The ox is laid at the root of the tree. Are y'all in the room? God wants us to know, brothers and sisters, any branch in him, any branch in him, according to John chapter 15 and verse 2, any branch in him that does not bear fruit, he takes it away. And he just told you just now that there are some branches you got to remove out of your life. Anything that's stopping you from being fruitful in this season, I want to tell you just right now, you ain't even have to do it. God gonna move it. Because God knows that you are a fruit-bearing tree, but there's some stuff that you have attached yourself to that he's saying, or some things that have attached itself to you, vice versa, that he says, I'm not going to let stay in your life in this season. Why? Because God is a jealous God who is madly in love with you. And he's not about to give you up just like that. The only way that can happen is if you have determined in your mind that you don't want to walk with him. And if you don't want to walk with him, my brothers and sisters, well, there's nothing he could do. He has to cut you off. Amen. Are y'all in here? Amen. A kingdom mindset, brothers and sisters, releases us to God's way of thinking. Amen. It releases us to the desires of God. What do you mean? God says, be ye holy. For I, the Lord God, I am holy. Amen. Are you hearing me? He says, be perfect. For God, I am perfect. That's what it means. God simply wants you to know, brothers and sisters, that you call my brothers and sisters to make a difference. Paul told the Roman saints, he said, I'm begging you man, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies as a living sacrifice. How? Holy and acceptable unto God, which is what? You're reasonable. That ain't you. Some people act like holiness is something, I mean, like holiness is, you got to pay for it. God says it's just your reasonable service. You think you're doing God a big favor to be holy. He says it's only your reasonable service. And then he tells us, and be ye transformed. By what? The renewing of our minds. All right? Be transformed by the renewing of your minds, that you may what? Prove what is that good and perfect and acceptable will of God. What's he trying to tell you? He's trying to tell you, be able to sing after the music stop. Are y'all here? He's trying to tell you, have victory in your spirit, brothers and sisters, after the praise has stopped. Are y'all still in the room? He's trying to tell you, believe, my brothers and sisters, when the bottom is falling out. You have to believe. A kingdom mindset will rejoice, my brothers and sisters, when there looks like nothing to rejoice about. Because why? God's way is not our ways, and God's thoughts are not our thoughts. And are y'all here? Hearing what I'm telling you? Sometimes it looks like things have come to destroy you, like it's going to finish you off, but you need to hear something. Brothers and sisters, God had made a vow. He has made a vow. The Lord God himself will fight for you. Are you hearing me? He will fight for you. All of those people that I'm talking about who understand the kingdom-minded people will dwell in the secret place of the Most High. God promises that you will abide under the shadow of the Almighty, and you will say of your God, he is your refuge, your fortress, your God. In him will you trust. In him will you put your trust. Another passage says, those who trust in the Lord shall be as Mount Zion, which cannot be removed, but abided forever. It doesn't matter how the enemy threatens you. Doesn't matter what kind of debt comes your way. You will declare, yea, do I walk through and feel the anointing of God. Through the valley of the shadow of death. Why? I will fear no evil. Why? For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Yea, thou prepares a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Surely Look at what you're, look at the prophetic now. Surely, look at the prophetic. I'm getting ready to stop. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me. See, when you have a kingdom mindset, brothers and sisters, you know what's, y'all ain't hearing me. You know what's about to happen. I don't know about tomorrow, but I know who holds my hand. Are y'all in the room? I don't know, but I surely know who holds my hand. And if God's got your hand, hallelujah, all hell can break loose. But the Bible declares, surely goodness and mercies shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Why? So I could behold the beauty of the Lord, and indeed I could inquire in his temple. Brothers and sisters, if you yield yourself in this season, if you yield yourself to the Holy Spirit, you will become fruitful. That's the fifth one. God wants us to become fruitful. Hallelujah. From the very beginning, he told us in Genesis, we are to be fruitful and multiply. Amen. Jesus says, my Father gets glory when you're fruitful. Amen. John 15 and verse 8, he says, henceforth is my Father glorified. Hallelujah. Henceforth is my Father glorified that you bear fruit, much fruit. And so are you, much fruit. And so, he says, so you will be my disciples. We are not God's disciples until we bear fruit. You hearing what I'm telling you? What you saying? I'm saying, listen, your gifts and talents can take you places, my brother. Watch this. It may be able to take you places, and it will, because the scripture says your gift will make room for you. But one thing I can tell you, you cannot bear the character of Jesus unless you're being fruitful. Are you all in the room? Fruitfulness, my brothers and sisters, reflects your maturity. And that's what we want. God wants us no longer to be as children who are tossed to and fro with every wind of doctrine, nor the slight cunningness of man. What he wants us to be, he wants us to be a matured people. Are y'all hearing me? A matured people who are walking, brothers and sisters, in the character of Jesus. So the fruit of the Spirit gives us the ability, my brothers and sisters, to stand the test of time. It gives us the ability, my brothers, to look like Jesus. So every time folk look at you, they see Jesus. Why? Because you are no longer tossed to and fro. You know who you are. You knows who you are. You are operating in this kind of mindset. And that's what God wants from us. Because that's the only way we're going to make a difference. Hello, somebody. Amen. And let me tell you something. You know, we used to sing in Sunday school, this little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. I'm going to let it shine. Shine all over the world. We used to come down to little Nassau town. Or Exuma town. I'm going to let it shine. Listen here, brothers and sisters. I need to tell you something. If you and I yield ourselves to the Holy Spirit, there is nothing that can stop us. Amen. All right? There is nothing that can stop us from walking in the purpose and in the destiny that God has designed for us. That's why this month, I'm telling you, this month is most essential to your walk with God. Because like no other month, can you really be identified with Jesus unless you have fruit? And this is why Jesus told his disciples, listen here. He said to them when in his departure, he says, you're going to do some greater things. You're going to do the works that I do, but you're also going to do greater things. Are you all in the room? I wonder if we could really believe God for doing greater things, man. Too many of us have this small mindset. You have this mindset, brothers and sisters, where you think everybody else is greater. Oh, they are more anointed than me. And then because you feel someone else is more anointed than you, then you start, watch this, then you start adopting a low self-esteem. You adopt a spirit, my brothers and sisters, that's not conducive to who you have been called to be. God has said, he says, you are the head and not the tail. You are above only and not beneath. You are the righteousness of God in Jesus the Christ. And only when we know who we are, brothers and sisters, can we get ready for worldview. Do you know that God has appointed you to worldview? Are y'all in the room? God has not called us to ordinary lives. Are you hearing me, brothers and sisters? You have been assigned to greatness. If you are the children of Abraham, through Jesus the Christ, you've been called to greatness. And that is why in this season, brothers and sisters, we must change our mindset now. Amen. We must accept what the Holy Spirit has been assigned to do. What has he been assigned to do? Not only to, watch this, not only to release gifts in our lives. And when I say not only to release gifts, most of us only focus in one area. We want to hear tongues. You know, some folk back in the day, they say, you say you got the Holy Ghost, let me hear the evidence. That evidence is. Well, if you read the text, if you read 1 Corinthians 12 or 1 Corinthians 14, you'll see not everybody is assigned to speak. Boy, I got to do some teaching on these things. I really got to do some teaching on these. Not everybody is assigned to speak. Y'all still here? And so when we understand this, brothers and sisters, he's not only assigned to give us gifts, but he's also assigned to give us fruit. Amen. Because he wants us in the image and in the likeness of God. What that means, likeness, character of God. Amen. In other words, he wants you. Let me show you how Paul puts it. Paul puts it like this in Galatians 5 and verse 22. He says, but the fruit of the Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit is love. The fruit of the Spirit is love. Oh, God. I ain't going to be able to go much further. Allow me to get this one out. I'm going to get this one out. Just this one. The fruit of the Spirit is love. Because as I stated earlier, in another month, everything hinges on love. Everything is wrapped up in love. Are you hearing me? Amen. Everything is wrapped up in love. And when everything else vanishes, there are three things that the scripture admonishes us. Now abided. Faith. Hope. Love. That's Corinthians 13. But it says, but it identifies and it says, but the greatest of these is love. Everything functions on love. God wants us to know, brothers and sisters, that love, when you see love in this context, it is in the agape. It's talking about unconditional love. Unconditional love. Love, my brothers and sisters, is not a feeling. It is a choice.
If we are to produce kingdom fruit, we must be completely dependent upon the Word of God. I pray this message has blessed your heart. If you would like a copy of this message in its entirety, please call our media ministry, 341-0502, and place your order today. We would be delighted to get that CD and or DVD right out to you. Neighbors and friends, I want to extend a very warm invitation to you to join us in our 8 a.m. Morning Glory service. That service is already in progress. And our 10:30 a.m. Divine Worship service. Listen, it's not too late to get up and get ready and join us in this service. I believe a word awaits you. Until next time, this is our year of kingdom advancement and manifestation. Be blessed. Thank you for listening to our program today. For prayer, counseling, or encouragement, please call us 341-0502. Send us an email, united.faith@yahoo.com, or like us on Facebook, United Faith Ministries International. We would be delighted to hear from you. Wishing to join us? Meet us at our sanctuary at number 126 Fire Trail Road East every Sunday morning at 8 a.m. for our Morning Glory Worship Service and 10:30 a.m. for our Divine Worship Service. For all other service times and broadcast schedules, please visit our website, www.ufmi.org. On behalf of our senior pastor, Apostle Falman Ferguson, and the family of United Faith Ministries International, thank you for sharing with us. Join us next week right here on this station, and may the Word of God richly dwell in you.